Hi, and welcome to a new video of this MOOC. In this video, we are going to learn the parts in which an Angular sample application is divided and how it works to start rendering our views and to start working with the logic we define in the application. When we create a sample application using the command line interface tools that Angular provides to us, we can see that it renders a welcome application with a title that is get from the logic of the component. But what is actually happening? How Angular is building our application to finally displaying the template of this main component in the web page, okay, in the web browser. The main entry point of the application is this file, the main TS file we can find in our folder structure. This file just compiles the application and bootstraps the application root module, the application module. We can see here in this line how we are saying to Angular what is the main module that will act and as the entry point in our application. Then when we go to this application module, we can see that this application is declaring every component that will be included under this module. Okay, so every component we create and we want to include in this module should be included here in this declaration list. Okay, of course, if we in the future divide our application in several modules, we will just include in each module the components that belongs to each specific module. But when talking about simple application, we just have this application module as the main and root module of our application, and every component available in our application should be included here in this declaration list. Okay? Then we can see how we are also telling Angular to bootstrap this application component as the main component included in our application. What Angular internally does with this order is to create the application component for us and inserts the view that this component renders in the index page of our application. Okay? Finally, of course, this main component, the application component, renders the template that is defined in its template file, applicationComponent.html5, in the selector of index.html5 defined in the metadata. We can see here that in the component metadata, we are defined that this component should be rendered in this HTML tag. And finally, the component applies to the rendered view the styles defined in the application component CSS class. Of course, these things are configurable and we can set them here in the component. So let's see with detail what is happening. As we have shown before, our server, our web server, renders the index.html page and sends it to the web browser. Okay, as we can see here, we have included the application root tag. In the application module, we have configured that the component we want to render is the application component. And according to the application component, we have to render the application component HTML template that is defined here in this file. We can see in this file that we have included an header one tag that says welcome to title. And of course, this will be injected here in the application root tag because we have configured here in the component that this is the selector in which we have to include the template. What we are going to render here in this property defined between double brackets? The value of the property that is defined here in title property of the component logic. And finally, if we have defined extra styles in the application component CSS file, these styles will be, of course, applied to the part of the view we have rendered here in this tag. Okay, so with this, I think it's clear how Angular bootstraps our application and how it starts putting in each place of the application each part of this component according to the logic we have defined. Let's take a look to the tree of files Angular has created when we have created or generated this new project. Okay, we can see that in Hello World we have a set of folders and files, but the main folder in which we have to start working is the source folder in which the logic of our application is included. We can see here that under application folder in source, we can see the main application module and the files that corresponds to the new component we have just created. The rest of the files and folders available in the folder tree are part of the logic that supports the application building, the test, the documentation, the deployments, and so on, and are not needed for start deploying or developing basic applications with Angular. So now we have learned how a sample project created with Angular command line interface tool works and how it is divided in terms of folders and files. See you in the next video. Bye.